Yo, YouTube, what's crackin' like a jack and smack? It is Waffle Man for video, and happy National Video Games Day, man. Seriously. But anyways, man, I'm tired of shit, man. 2K just went gold, which means 2K's being shipped out. Might be at your local GameStop, might be at your local mom and pop shop. So check it out, man. Ask them if they got 2K18, if they're selling it. You know what I'm saying? Get that shit early. But anyways, right? 2K dev again, of course, Zach. Released more information about dribble tiers in NBA 2K18. So apparently people always have been wondering how to get speed boosting this year, and people are always been confused. So this guy, one of the 2K devs, cleared it up on how to reach level 3 tier dribble moves. So level tier 3 dribble moves, you have to have an 86 ball handling. So as you see on the chart right here, these are all the archetype with 86 ball control and also a 90 ball control. And not only that, it tells you the height. So you look at the primary, passing and ball handling. You almost every single one of them has an 86 ball control. So if you do want to be able to speed boost and be able to pull off some great dribble moves, make a pass and ball handling as your primary archetype. And your secondary can literally be anything. Even though the height is definitely going to change that. So you see, as a pure passing and ball handler, you can be 6'10 and have an 86 ball control. Then after that, you got the shot creator. So a lot of people are going to be making passing as their primary and a shot creator as their secondary, because like I said, that's a pretty good archetype right there. And you could be 6'7. And then for three-point shots, you can't be 6'7. So these are things to think about if you want to be able to get that 86 ball control. Now, the only other archetype that's able to get an 86 ball control after that is the shot creator. As you see right here, the shot creating, passing, and ball handling as your secondary, you can be 6'8 maximum and still get an 86 ball control. Like I said, man, shot creator is going to be the one of the most popular archetypes. And then right below that is the pure shot creator. My build right there. I think I'm really going to make a pure shot creator, man. Because listen, if I make a shot creator, he's probably going to be 6'3 or 6'4 anyways. You got to be 6'5 or shorter as a pure shot creator to get 86 ball control. So right there, that's already good. But let's take a look at this, right? And by the way, if you're driving and finishing, you have passing and ball handling, you can also get an 86 ball control. But I don't think a lot of people are going to make builds like that. But look at the 90 ball control. This is where it gets interesting. So for 90 ball control, you basically have to be a passing and ball handler for almost every single thing, and it does limit your height a lot more for that 90 ball control. However, again, the only other archetype other than a primary ball handler in the game to be able to reach a 90 ball control is the shot creator. So if you make a shot creator as a primary and your secondary is ball control and you're 6'5 or shorter, which is what you should be anyways if you're going to make a shot creator like that, you're going to be able to get a 90 ball control. That's insane. This is why I was thinking about making this build. This is probably 90% I'm going to be making a shot creator playmaker, because it's so lit. You get the mid-range, like I said, the ball handling is there. Still got good layups and dunks and stuff like that. Your 3-point's not as bad. The thing is, do you want a 90 ball control? That's the thing. You get new rhythm dribbles with the 90 ball control. But some people might just settle for the 86 ball control, man. But listen, that shot creator is going to be the most popular archetype, man. So here it is, man. This is the chart. If you make a 3-point shooter as primary, you won't be able to speed boost, I'm assuming, then. Driving and finisher, you won't be able to speed boost. You've got to be, your primary has to be either passing and ball handling or shot creating. Otherwise, you won't be able to speed boost in NBA 2K18. You gotta have that 86 ball control. You want the elite tier 3 dribble moves, you gotta have the 86 ball control. You want the new rhythm dribbles in the game, the elite, the best rhythm dribbles in the game, you gotta have a 90 ball control. So yeah, man, let me know what you think in the comment section. What archetype are you making? And now that this has come out, are you gonna change your shot creator build or playmaker build? I hope I see a lot more passing and ball handlings as primaries, but we're really gonna see shot creators more this year, man. honestly. But anyways, I'm out for now. Leave a like for more. Peace.